Denmark apparently is the happiest country, is that true?
Dalai Lama has given his blessing to a new course of evening classes available throughout the UK, which promises to make participants happier.
Happiness. The key to it, let's face it, has preoccupied us for some time.
Hey, my name is Kaylynn Wilson. And a little over a year ago, I started filming the adventures that me and my friends would find ourselves on. And when I signed up for this English class, I was already over the idea of assigned readings, especially about some old dude who moved into the woods. I was pretty doubtful that I was going to get anything out of the class besides checking off another box on my liberal studies list. But when we were assigned this video project, I got pretty excited. But that also meant that I had to actually read the book. So, after some brainstorming and hours of reading Henry Thoreau's Walden, I came up with a pretty cool project, and I'm so excited to show it to you. Happiness. Well, after researching this topic, I've come to find that happiness is something that's different for all of us. For some, happiness is the lack of a negative in a situation. Some people say happiness is an overwhelming positive. But they can both agree on is that happiness is a feeling. Henry David Thoreau said in his journal, "Man is the artificer of his own happiness. Let him beware how he complains of the disposition of circumstances, for it is his own disposition that he blames." This is stating that we are the captain of our own ship. Even if someone brings all these ideas of happiness into his life, the one that is the most important is that they have to actually own it. They can choose to ignore happiness and it will certainly continue to be ignored. That's unique within itself. Happiness is a feeling, but also a mindset. We have to accept happiness into our life. That's everyone's own responsibility. No one can do that for us. We can go to others for help in seeing it in a different way, like a group of friends who helps you see things from a whole new perspective. Everyone goes through a rough patch in their life, even Thoreau did. And while those things happen, we need to find a change in scenery. Now, I'm definitely not saying to ditch your responsibilities and build yourself a house in the middle of nowhere. I'm saying sadness is something that demands to be felt. Sadness is important and necessary. But if we dwell on the negative around us, we do not progress. We must at one point push forward and allow happiness to enter our lives again. With happiness being something that differs from person to person, along with the definition of happiness, one universal idea is that happiness is a positive and that it drives everyone. Happiness is a goal and what most people strive for. Many people will try to tell you what happiness is. Maybe it's sitting on the beach with a good book, or maybe it's the bar in the middle of an arts district, or maybe it's both. The definition of happiness is your own. How you measure your own happiness is also your own, and it's up to you to allow yourself happiness. That is one of the things on a very small list that you have full control over. Embrace that fully, now that you're aware of that fact. Change is uncomfortable, but it's necessary. Sadness demands to be felt, and it will be. After that, one must push through and try to find a change in scenery. For the sake of progressing, which we all owe ourselves, we must always keep progressing. And surround yourself with those who push you there. Thank you.